Hi there, everybody. I am here live with you to tell you a little bit about my new World War II release called When the Heart Sings, and it's releasing in October, so there's a little bit to wait yet until the book comes out, but the cover is finished, and I'm really excited to show it to you. Some of you got to see it yesterday because you were my newsletter subscriber, so you got a sneak peek there, and a special contest just for my newsletter subscribers. Those of you who aren't my newsletter subscribers, make sure you hop over to my website at liztolsma.com. You can sign up for my newsletter there, and there are going to be lots of other fun things happening throughout the next few months as we get ready for release, and when it releases, things that are exclusive just to my newsletter subscribers. And I can tell you, Gilead is really good about releasing things like sneak peeks of the book and the first chapter and stuff like that. So if you want to get in on that action, make sure you head over there and sign up for my newsletter if you aren't a subscriber. I promise I'm not like Bath and Body Works. I don't send out a whole bunch every day or anything like that. Once a month, sometimes a little more if we're doing something special like we are this month. So I'm glad to see that lots of you are here and lots of you have joined in on the conversation. So I'm glad to see all of you, some familiar faces and some names that I'm not quite so familiar with. So welcome everybody. I hope you're having a good evening and that spring is starting to arrive wherever it is that you are. We finally had our first warm day, yay. So I was really excited about that. Well, I guess since we have a lot of people online now, and I've given everybody a few minutes to get here, that we can get started with the fun and everything that's going to be going on. I'm going to make you wait for the cover just for a little bit longer. I want to tell you a little bit about When the Heart Sings, and I've teased it a little bit on social media this past couple of days, that this is one of the most deeply personal books for me, and I think the hardest book that I've ever had to write. I don't plan my books out when I start to write them. I pretty much just sit down and I have an idea, I have characters developed, and I sit down and I just write, and I write what comes to me. And I remember that very first day that I sat down to start When the Heart Sings, and I put my hands on the keyboard and the words started coming, and it was not the story that I expected that it would be. So it took me by surprise. It really did. It wasn't the story that I thought I was going to write. So that's kind of the fun part about being a writer. Sometimes you're surprised by what your characters do and how the story goes. And that's what happened with When the Heart Sings. Many of you know, my husband and I have three children, and all of our children have come to us through international adoption. And I had so many people ask me, when are you going to write a book about adoption? And it's such a personal story for me and my struggle with infertility and how we came to be parents through adoption. And it was just something I was never quite ready to share with people. It's a hard place to go still sometimes. But when I sat down to write this book, the time felt right, and the characters just were struggling with the same things that I have struggled with in the past. And so this beautiful story became so much of my heart. I share a lot of my heart in this book. And the characters struggle with infertility, they struggle with infant loss, and there is a beautiful adoption story woven throughout the book. And so there were some passages that I have to admit I cried hard as I wrote them, and it was very difficult for me to go back and edit some of these sections because I had to reread places where I bared my heart, things that the characters were feeling that I have felt too. And so that's what made the book very difficult, but I hope that when you read it, that you'll see how personal it is for me, and that it will touch your heart as much as it touched mine. It was very good for me to finally write a book about adoption. So those of you who have been asking for that, it's finally going to happen in October. The book, as you know, the series, that I've been writing, this new World War II series, Music of Hope series, is set in Eastern Europe. So the first book, The Melody of the Soul, which is out now, was set in Czechoslovakia. This book is set in Poland, and it takes a different look at what World War II was like in Poland. I think we know a lot about the Jewish Polish population that was really decimated by the Nazis during the Second World War and all the camps. But what a lot of people don't realize is that a lot of Polish Christians also lost their lives during the war. The Nazis had this list of people that they wanted exterminated from the planet. The Jews just happened to be at the top of the list. But the Slavic people, so the Poles and the Slovakians and people from that region, they were also on the list. They were just a little farther down than the Jews. But in Poland, the Nazis did begin their systematic, I don't know, want to use the word extermination because they weren't doing that yet, but they were working on their plan to get rid of the Poles as well. And they sent many Polish Christians to labor camps, slave labor camps. And while they were not extermination camps like Auschwitz or Mauthausen or any of those, they were not pleasant places to be. They worked with people very hard. The conditions were very poor. There was a lot of disease and sickness, and many, many of them never came home. There was a policy where they resettled Germans who were displaced from their homes during by the war, especially Ukrainian Germans living in the Ukraine, and they forced people out of their homes and off their land to be given to the Germans. And so, the main characters in this book, Teodor and Natia, are among the people displaced by the Germans and taken to a labor camp. And they are separated when they get to the labor camp. Teodor is taken to a factory to work, and Nadia is chosen by one of the German women in the town to come and work for her. And this was a very common occurrence that sometimes the women were taken separately and worked in the homes, in private homes. And so it's very difficult for Teodor and Nadia to be separated. They have just suffered a devastating loss. And yet they still want to communicate with each other. They're a couple very much in love. And it is through her song and her singing to Teodor as she passes the factory every day to go to market that they communicate with each other. And in the middle of all of this, a Jewish infant arrives on the doorstep of the German home where Natia is working. And an unlikely friendship develops, and Natia takes this child in and literally hides him right underneath the nose of her Nazi captor. And this was not something that I came up with just out of the clear blue, out of my brain. As I was doing research on these Poland lagers, as they're called, or Polish labor camps, I ran across an instance where there were a group of women who were hiding Jews in the basement of a home of a Nazi officer, and they managed to successfully hide those Jews during the war. I won't give away what happens in my book, but you'll have to read it in October and find out. So I'm really excited to share that with you, taking a little bit different view of what life was like for Polish Christians during World War II. Arletta asks, isn't today International Holocaust Memorial Day? Boy, that's a really good question. I am not sure about that. I didn't see anything on social media about that, but I've been out most of the day, so it is possible. Wouldn't that be cool if I was doing this on that day? And does anybody else have any other questions, or shall we just move right to unveiling the cover for When the Heart Sings? Jim and Lori asked, tissues will definitely be needed. Yeah, I think so. I think tissues will be needed. I cried as I wrote the book. Arletta says that International Holocaust Memorial Day was on her day planner at work. So that's really cool. I did not know that when we planned this. We did not know that, but that's really neat how that worked out. So yeah, we have to remember the Holocaust of the Jews, but we also have to remember that a lot of non-Jewish people, a lot of Christians also lost their lives during the Holocaust. Okay, well, if I'm not seeing any other questions or anything pop up, so you guys must be ready for the unveiling of the cover for When the Heart Sings. So before I do that, we worked really hard on this cover. I have to tell you, we went back and forth, and there were a lot of different additions that we went through before we came up with this. We wanted it to reflect the tone of the book and also to sort of match with the melody of the soul, because it's part of a series, even though they're standalone books. So we went through a lot. We went back and forth with a lot of things. The team at Gilead was fantastic, and they really listened to me, and I was able to have a lot of input on this cover, and I think they did a great job with it. Linda asked, what books do you use for research? That's a really good question. I use a lot of different books, and I use the internet. If you go onto the... I believe it is the Holocaust, it's the U.S. Holocaust Museum website. It has a lot of interviews with people who survived the Holocaust, and they have some good interviews on there with people who survived Poland lagers, and they're just reading a lot about Poland lagers and about the people who survived them. It was hard to get a lot of information about this because, if you recall, as soon as the Germans left, the Soviets came in, and Poland became a Soviet satellite. And the Soviets did not teach about World War II. I spoke to one Polish woman who works at a Polish deli that I go to, and she told me she didn't know much about World War II in Poland because they were never taught it in school. So this was a very hard book to research also. Okay, well, I hope you all love this cover because they worked very hard on it, and I think we got something that's very, very beautiful. So are you ready? On your mark, get set. Here, let me be careful not to pull this down here. There we go. Come on. And there we go. Okay. So this is the cover for When the Heart Sings. It shows a street in a little Polish town. Arletta is saying Holocaust Memorial Day in Canada. So it's that in Canada. Well, if we have anybody from Canada, that's great. Great to see you. So we worked really hard to get the woman and the baby on there because they play a really important part in there, and the Polish town there to give a little feel of what it's like. And we use the same script for the title of the book as we used for the Melody of the Soul. So I think they did, in the end, we came up with a really beautiful cover, and I'm very, very excited to share it with you. And I can't wait for you to read it in October. And like I said, Gilead's really good about giving out little sneak peeks, so make sure that you've signed up for my newsletter on my website so that when we are ready to release a little sneak peek to you, that you're there and you get it and you're ready to go. And then also, I'm running a little contest. One of you lucky people will get to win a copy of the book, and we will send it out to you when the book releases in October. And I'm so glad you all love it. I was nervous about that because I know Melody of the Soul was such a beautiful cover. And I'm very pleased to know that you guys like this one. So anyway, if you would like to win a copy of the book when it comes out, what you need to do is head over to my website. That's liztolsma.com. I make it really easy for you. And as soon as I'm done here, I'm going to pop over there and I'm going to put up a post that has the book cover and a little blurb about the book. And then down at the bottom is a trivia question. And the prize will go to the person who answers the trivia question closest, okay? And I think I need to just tweak that, a percentage. Give me a percentage. That's a clue to the answer, the trivia question over on my website, liztolsma.com. You have to go over there, Facebook rules and everything like that. So does anybody else have any other questions? Otherwise, I think we will end this. I thank you so much for joining me. I thank you for the questions that you asked and for the input. I'm glad you're as excited about the book as I am, and I hope that you really enjoy it when it comes out in October. Keep looking for it, and it is available for pre-order on Amazon right now, but just the paperback. They don't have the Kindle copy up for pre-order yet on Amazon. So if you want a paperback copy, you can hop over to Amazon now and you can pre-order it. And if you want to wait until the Kindle copy is available for pre-order, follow me on social media and I will be sure to post when that becomes available for you. Rebecca asks, are there plans for another book in this series? Yes, there are. I am working on the third book in this series. It has a working title, The Music Within, and we'll have to see if we go with that or not. And that one's going to be set in Hungary. And so, I just wrote another chapter today, so I'm working hard on that one. And that will be out sometime next year. I don't have an exact release date for that one yet. So there are more books in the works, and I have more in my mind. I have more books in my brain than I could possibly write in my lifetime, I think. So as long as they keep publishing them, I'm going to keep writing them. So thank you so much for joining me. It's always been fun. And be sure to head over to my website now. I'm going to go over there and post the post right now and enter the contest to win a copy of When the Heart Sings when it releases in October. Have a wonderful evening, everybody. Thanks so much for joining me.